sort of briefly that my and so in the middle would be sort of a parking area, above ground parking, and the rest of the parking that balances is supposed to be there. Does that answer your question? It looks weird, but it's so weird. The area that's not to them is what is not proposed is not going to be this one. It's approximately twice the size.
is going to be into our main area, close to the so I'll call the using it yet because prior to this particular social event, the fact that people don't have that benefit twice in the country, that nearly every mile you can get the price. So they changed the rules to limit it to, I think, 2 or 3 per person to go to the grocery and all that, like 50 to 100. So any of you on big huge plan, you can just receive some consumer health assistance, which you can pay for. Price for the event because it was a very successful fundraiser for the city. Also, I want to pass on to my colleagues at the Seniors with the Rise. The key question they put to me in the meeting was, does anybody on the council read our minutes? I said, no, just a show of hands, please. So I can tell them what we need to do with the minutes. Please put your hand on it if you have to. Don't make me go to this common record. Because I'm sure that we keep doing the same right. I read them, I answered the best of all of them. I read them. I don't understand what they created them. But to anybody who said, maybe one of them that you're interested in what they're doing there is the center of the reform and their obligations. Thank you. Thanks, Council. Thanks, Council. say across the nation, we did not find that Thank you. councillor for the member, please withdraw and join the debate from the podium.
Thank you. Mayor Linton and councillors,
16 years, we need 200 years old. Will we be able to secure a wider farm community in the next 200 years, or 100 years, or 50 years, with the growth projections stipulated? Sustainable growth needs water, correct? If we run out, we have to provide the community by buying. very much about having an open, transparent government and listen to the wishes of the community. I think what we have to look into this room tonight is hear that community wishes. They want this council and this township to clearly express this opposition to this. I think we have an obligation as the councillors of this community, as the leaders of this community, to honor those wishes. And so I'm very much looking forward to a motion tonight that Council Member Linton brings forward. I think it's needed, I think it's important, and I think we need to address it. But this is what I'm saying. I'm a believer that the need for water to sustain life is more important than the need for water to sustain tourism.
Thank you.
myself, our CEO, archaeologist, and director of infrastructure services, went and had a face-to-face meeting at Hackfest Park with Minister Nicole Murray and his full staff team that we explained the position to them. In the opinion of technically, he was there to help you guys, and he anticipated that approach was much more proactive and a much more effective approach if the council voted initially to the residents. Nothing's happened on this plan for how many months? Yes, it's not even getting a permit for the first couple of months. In the first couple of months, the worst case scenario, nothing's happened. And that tells me that our approach is working. I know that residents in this case is nothing. But I think it's the last option we should take. Because we are doing everything that we can to take other, make other moves and to be relevant in this process. I don't think we've used other options. I'd like to put this in the future. I'd like to see what other options we can have to try and get control. The resolution is going to be something. It's going to be something that's definitely going to have to go off in this community. What I want is I want us as leaders to take that position and say, how can we take control of the situation? I don't think all of that can do it. And I don't think the time is enough for resolution. I think that time might come. It might come in a month. But I think there's a couple of moves that we can make here. I think there's a couple of times that we have that we can move forward. And so I'm not ready to support my solution at this point. 2 months from now, that could be a better thing. But at this time, I think we need something else to do. And our approach is working. It's very clear that the minister's office is very clear. And whenever you talk to this, this council, this council is going to do what's in the best interest of the citizens long term. There's no question that all of a sudden we want to take some water to the fact that we have to look after our water resources, not right now, but for 50 years in the future, 60 years in the future, 100 years in the future. I'm committed to that. This class is committed to that. And we have to think about what we're tackling at this time. I think we have something else to play before we do this resolution. I think this resolution is still in the corner right now. I don't think we can be in that corner because I think we have all the options that we can do right now.
Mr. Mayor, I just want to hear you say a couple of different things that you've said. And I think even just thinking about how we speak about the resolutions going forward to the parents, definitely we did go through a minority, we did put us in the primary, and we said that we had this kind of that unique sort of background kind of thing. Would you be willing to have us set up a date where we really want to look for the decision? Because the resolution to me, even if we need to post a new resolution, we see it as an option to council pitches for us that we really want to know. And actually, I've spoken to a number of cities doing this as well. We really need to have some time for you to get the comfort that there is a clue, I understand, I'm actually agreeing with the concept of the resolution approves the board. So to change the mind, and then we're afraid of concern is that we don't want to slam the doors of businesses that they want to talk to us in the future. In my opinion, they're already offended because we forced their hand by getting them off the table. The second thing I want to say is we made a public statement recently that was picked up by an Oxford case in which we stated that the township made our offer to purchase keep our water supply safe from commercial water taking long into the future. If I was to ask the executive reading these words in the National Post or the World Mail or wherever it came from, from the desk for you, I would just simply say, hey, it's pretty clear that the mayor and possibly his council doesn't really want us in the community. So if you're worried that this resolution is somehow going to shut this door, your statements are ridiculous. On the issue of the province, I appreciate everything you and your staff have done to take on the case to Queen's Park. But I think the concern of the province for our resources goes beyond just the presentation of the media back when the media appeared in Mr. Mayor's office. So again, I say I don't think this resolution is all of a sudden going to change the mind of the clients in terms of how they're thinking about water resources in the future. Because they know that growth is occurring all through the Green Belt, and all around the Green Belt, in the places that water resources not just center point. It's all the communities that are affected by the growth tables. Surely to goodness, there's enough sense in the cabinet and the premier's office to know that water has to be available to accommodate the growth that they're projecting for the province of Ontario. So again, when I look at that from that perspective, I say, in no way will this resolution make the province mark the absence from this, because their agenda is much bigger than just the presentation that they're going to. So, I don't see the reason for the delay. I don't think 30 days is going to matter. I don't think 2 months is going to matter. We need to get moving. We've got our people here from the community expressing their wishes. They've lobbied us. They've told us how they feel.
First thing I want to say is that this is a message that
first time we're going through this, and then I have no work for this one. Because that is not an asset of the world that it is. And the problem is just what we do to the problems. And if we don't make the pressure with this one, then we might be defeated. We might have an opportunity to help you. So that is just the beauty of the story. The Ministry of Environment is currently studying the feasibility of granting a plantation permit to Pisa at the end of the forest service in Wrighthaven. Was it performed in an approach opposition to the license of this permit? And is it permitted for an expected length of conservation of Pisa Linton to take leadership on the message issue by demonstrating to the entire people and taking water from the ground that aquifers supplies of plants that companies produce a bottom water that is no longer appropriate or consistent with the policy of conservation of Oxford's water protection. The official position of the council has been wait for the science. The issue with this position is the controversial issue of language and science. Three different majors on the issue provided three different opinions based on the same data. The GRC answered the process of food and structural food study. The policies of the Minister of Government are beginning to get out of danger and can't be complete to the final data. While there are questions about the science, the following are not in question. Our population is only the most popular in the United States, and it's not unrealistic to believe it will continue at the same level of many generations. Climate change is real. Food, drought, are very possible. In these days of rapid climate change, the use of places to run and get out to the medical and consultation for reducing the functional costs. This cancer must exercise a precautionary principle and do everything we can to protect the sustainability of the watershed and the integrity of the local water supply. Our official position is also the change. Our unofficial position is also the change. Maryland has been publicly stating that the township may not have the purchase of money to keep its water supply safe for commercial water delivery long into the future. This change in narrative must become our official position. Therefore, the letter from the mayor's office to the general standard council and environment minister, Ben Miller, stating this council's opposition to since community groups have sent water over to two water parcels, sent letters to Premier Linton and Minister Linton expressing their collective concern that the issuance of a permit to exit to take part in the development of the site is not in the best